Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you my super quick and easy summer makeup look. I am definitely not a makeup expert, so if you were looking for that, this is not the right channel for you. But I've had several people, like probably 10 or 12 people, message me or comment in the past week or two asking how I'm doing my makeup, and I have changed it now that the weather has gotten warmer, and I thought I would share it with you. This video should be relatively short because it's just a few items, and it's a pretty quick and easy, only takes me like 5 minutes to do. So if you're wondering what this background is, because this is obviously not my house, if you watch my vlogs, you know I am not at home. We are currently in Vero Beach, Florida for my cousin's wedding, which was last night. It is Sunday on the day that I'm filming this. It's Mother's Day today. So we are here for, like I said, we were here for my cousin's wedding, and then we leave actually tomorrow morning for our Disney cruise. So the day that this video is going up is actually our last day of the cruise. We are getting home, back home, on the day that this video goes up and live, which is weird to think about. If you have followed along with my channel, then you know that I do a lot of vlogging and a lot of weekly vlogging, but I did not vlog this wedding weekend. I was planning on it originally, and then I decided at the end of the day I just wanted to relax. So also, I'm at the beach, y'all. Like, my hair is frizzy and just kind of a hot mess, and I'm in like a t-shirt. Also, this is a good indication of why this makeup look is just super light and super easy, because it's very hot and humid here, and it's also very hot and humid in Texas, and doing like a full face of full coverage makeup in the summer months is not my favorite because it just melts off my face. So I like something that's a little bit lighter. So let me just jump right in to my easy summer makeup that I've been doing for the past probably month or so, and just loving the way that it wears throughout the day and how easy it is to apply. So no big shock if you've been following along. This is the first thing that I have been using. It is the Bare Minerals Complexion Rescue Tinted Hydrating Gel Cream. It's basically a tinted moisturizer. I am the color Opal, which is shade 01, obviously. And I just bought another tube of this because there's only a little bit more left in this. So I just put it right on my fingers. I always wash my hands before I do my makeup. Just put like a little bit on there. And this has SPF 30 in it, which is also good since my skin color is Opal, to make sure that I'm protecting myself, because even in Texas, if I'm just like driving, I can still get a sunburn because it's just so hot and the sun is so strong. So I like this because it just kind of evens out my skin tone. It's not heavy. It doesn't smell like sunscreen, which is huge. I hate when things smell like sunscreen. Also, I'm sorry, during this video I'm going to be looking in the, not in the viewfinder, but at the screen above pretty much the whole time, because there's not a mirror behind me. There's a wall of windows behind me. Actually, I'll insert like a little pan of the room and show you. This room is wonderful. We rented a beach house, my family and I, and Riley and I are in this room down on the first floor, and it actually has a door that walks out right to the beach. It's so beautiful. Anyway, the second thing after I've done, like, just evened out my skin tone and protected my skin and added some extra moisture, I have loved for a long time now this Maybelline Master Conceal Camouflaging Concealer. I am shade 10, which is the fairest shade, I believe. I'm sure it is. I always wear the fairest shade. I've been using this for a while. If I'm doing like my beauty blender, I'll do it on my hand, but literally this is usually what I do. I do like a little drop, couple little drops. I know this isn't like I said, if you're looking for like professional makeup videos, like, this is not the video, but this is what I do in the summertime when I just need to like get out the door and also not have makeup that is melting off my face when it's 97 degrees at 7 a.m. So this is what I do. Just get rid of some of this under eye bag, some of the redness around my nose. Takes me no time at all. Oh, and this brush is called the Expert Face Brush by Real Techniques. I really like it for doing concealer because it doesn't absorb the product the way that my hands do. My nose gets kind of red, and around my mouth it gets a little red, so I do a little bit of some color correcting there. Let me turn my brightness down a little bit so it's a little bit more accurate. There we go. Now you can see the bags. Good enough. Then, let me get the things I've already done to the side. The next thing I do is fill in my eyebrows. This is the Revlon ColorStay Brow Pencil in the color 210 Soft Brown. Here is what it looks like. On one end, it has a little spoolie. And on the other end, it has a twist up pencil. So I'm gonna need a little mirror to do this. So I just kind of, well, sometimes I'll brush them out. I have like very thick eyebrows, and I always have. And I don't dislike them, but they require a little bit of extra love and attention. So I just kind of take this and I just kind of do short strokes. And after I do that, they always look really crazy because I just have such thick eyebrows. So I always use the spoolie to go in and just soften it up. Now I just look crazy because I haven't put mascara on yet. But that's just my natural brow. It's just really thick. It always has been. Whenever I would go get my eyebrows waxed in high school, the girl would call me Brooke Shields because I guess Brooke Shields has really thick eyebrows. It's like a blessing and a curse. They're kind of always a hot mess, but also I think I'd rather them be too thick than too thin. Okay, I look really crazy right now. Okay, so then the next thing that I do is I use eyeliner. This, I am at the tail end of this one. This is the Smashbox Limitless Eyeliner in Onyx. You can barely even read it, so I don't even know why I'm holding it up. And I do it on my upper lash line just to kind of, or my upper waterline, just to kind of make my lash line look thicker. So I just kind of go on the inside and just, especially on the, you know what I'm saying? Don't you love this makeup tutorial? Okay, so I'm done. See how it adds just a little bit of definition? Makes the eyebrows look less crazy. Next, I go in with an eyelash curler, and I usually do one eye at a time because I am all about the lashes. I love lashes, and this has been my favorite mascara for a while now. It is the Waterproof Voluminous Million Lashes Mascara. Do not get the not waterproof version of this. It's horrible, but the waterproof version of this is stinking awesome. I absolutely love it. So I curl, and then I do several layers on one side, and then I curl, and then I do several layers on the other side. Okay, so that's one eye done. See the difference? I think it makes a huge difference. Okay, so once the lashes are done, I feel like I look less crazy because I have blonde lashes. Now, to be honest, sometimes I'll just put on chapstick and this is it. Like, I feel good to go. But a lot of times what I'll do is, because it's this Bare Minerals Tinted Moisturizer is quite an oily finish, because it's probably because of the sunscreen in it, I'll take this, which is the Revlon ColorStay pressed powder in 880 translucent. I'll link whatever I can link below. I've probably bought about half of this stuff on Amazon, to be honest with you. And I'll use this powder brush, but especially if it's gonna be super hot, I actually will go into this little lower compartment and take this little, what are these called? Powder puff, something like that. And I actually will put it right under my eyes, because that's where most creasing happens, and right around my mouth, and a little bit on my forehead. And then I'll just pick up a little bit and I'll just quickly go over my face. Now, obviously, I have super pale skin and I'll tan just a tiny bit. And if I do tan just a tiny bit, I'll have to add in some bronzer and kind of warm it up. But even though I'm at the beach right now, I have been like aggressively putting on sunscreen because we're about to go on this cruise and I do not want to be sunburnt. I get sunburnt really easily, so I've been aggressively putting it on. All right, now I'm just gonna take a little bit of blush because I have naturally rosy cheeks, so when my face is just completely matte, I feel like I look crazy. Put a little bit on my cheeks. Oh, this is the e.l.f. It's a little palette. with bronzer and blush. It's in the color Fiji. Good enough. Can you tell that my dream is to become a makeup a beauty guru? That is not my dream. I would be horrible at that. And then I have been obsessed with this Revlon Ultra HD Lip Lacquer in HD Smoky Topaz. This is the color. It's really pretty. It has like a little gemstone on the top. And it's just like a really nice nudie gloss. And I've just been putting on a light layer because I just feel like it looks better. And then I'll just... This is like the realest of how it really takes me. It probably does take me about 5 or 7 minutes since I'm talking and explaining. This video is gonna be longer, but it's pretty quick. Then I deal with my hair. Sometimes I'll leave it down. A lot of times I'll throw it up in a ponytail. I curled it last night for the wedding, but it's so humid, the curls just kinda fall out, so. Most days, I just kind of try to like do a ponytail that's not completely slicked back. I'm at the point in my life where I'm like, my hair gets frizzy when it gets hot or when it's humid, which in the summer it's both hot and humid, and I don't need to try to hide it, and I'm not straightening my hair every day. So if you don't like it, too bad. That's really how I feel though. Like, I spent so much of my life trying to figure out ways to not make it frizzy. It just is in the summer. It's too bad. So that's my super, super easy and fast summer makeup routine. Sometimes I will keep my hair down or just not have it slicked back in a ponytail. But a lot of times, especially if I'm doing Etsy and I'm on the floor, I just want it off my face. So that is what I've been doing. All of these products, every single one of them, except for the eyeliner, which I'm not even, like, you could totally get a drugstore eyeliner. Everything's drugstore. I forgot to show this powder brush. This is Royal and Lane Nickel powder. This one is from Walmart, I believe. I really like it, this powder brush. And this blush brush is from Eco Tools. Again, I will link everything that I can link below, but I have been really happy with this. What I actually do is, if you know what my house looks like, you know that I have a makeup vanity in our bedroom that has all of my makeup on it. But for the summer, I have just kept all of this in like a big mason jar on our bathroom counter. So in the morning, I brush my teeth, wash my face, and then throw this makeup on really quickly, just like to make myself feel more pulled together. And then that's it. So I don't even go sit down at the vanity unless I have a reason why I want to have heavier makeup on, or just like more dramatic makeup on. So that's been my summer makeup look. I would love to hear from you. What summer products have you been loving that have been easy to put on, you know, now that it's warming up across the country? Thank you guys so, so much for watching. The next vlogs on my channel will be Disney cruise vlogs. So definitely subscribe if you're interested in that. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.